We have a star gracing our airwaves. And she's not just a star. She's talented. She's a sensational Irish star. She's here with me in the studio. Welcome.
Hello.
Hi, Ira. Good to see you.
And you too. How are you? You're looking so good this morning or this afternoon.
Thank you, but you are looking sexy as hell.
Thank you so much.
So I'm pretty sure you've been here before, obviously.
Yes.
But then this is the first time that I am...
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I've been to your meeting just once. I think Sharon invited me. But this is the first time that I am interviewing you, mm-hmm. or even like in very close proximity. So welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So it's a TK Talk box. It's going to be in three sessions, right? So the in-depth dialogue, the sauce revelation, and a part where you're going to be spilling the tea. It's like a this or that. So are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
First, how are you doing?
I'm doing amazing. I had a very long night.
Why was that?
They had me in the club.
Well, I mean, that means like you're the paid parent.
No, it wasn't paid. I had fun. I miss Lagos clubs, to be honest.
Okay. So does that mean that you have not been clubbing Lagos for a minute?
I have, but like I've not gone to like the mainland. I was in Ikeja, you know.
Oh, okay.
Vault Club, and it was a different vibe entirely. I really like enjoyed it.
So would you say, are you the kind of girl who loves it in the club? Like, do you have fun in the club?
I mean, like, if I'm with my people, I'm going to have fun. But, like, I feel like it just depends on what the vibes is, to be honest. But if I'm with my people, if I'm with my guys, my girls, then it's going to be fun. If we're celebrating something especially, it's going to be fun. Well, sometimes I just want to sleep.
Right now, what's the feeling? Just seeing how much you have come. What's the feeling? Is it, like, happiness, joy, satisfaction? What's the feeling? Ira, at this point, what's the feeling?
It is gratitude, intense gratitude.
Hmm.
That's just how I can explain it. It's just, I'm very grateful for where I am right now.
Did you envy? I mean, you seem to be confident. Even I saw some of your pictures before you even joined Mavens, where you're like a model or something. But did you see yourself at this point? Did you envision this?
Yes, very much. I feel like because I envisioned it, that's why I'm here now. Like, I always had, like, big dreams and, like, big plans and all of that. So, like, I knew I was going to be here at one point, you know. I still know I'm going to be bigger, you know. There's something I always say. I'm not going to allow myself to be something imperfectly, stop me from being something at all. Because, like, I'm scared of failing. I'm going to keep trying and keep trying until I become this mega superstar.
I love it. I love it.
Yes.
So we've come a long way from away, away, away.
We have. Oh.
Tell me about the evolution of Irish Star. Talk about it for a minute. Because it's really been pacey.
It's been because we did 3 years like last week. Irish Star.
Anniversary
of Irish Star, 3 years.
Ooh.
Last year. And I was just seeing my outfits in these music videos and my hair. I was like, God, what is this? Why did I wear that? Who told me to have that makeup on? I thought I was that girl then. For real.
Okay.
For real. But like, yeah, I've come such a long way, you know. I'm learning so much. I'm just like, I'm having a great time. The journey has been amazing. I'm so grateful for where I am. And yeah.
I don't know if that really explains the evolution of Ira yet, but
what do you want to know? And what do you want to know specifically? Ask me specifically what you want to know.
What?
Because it's just so much. It's so much.
And I get that. What has been your most memorable accomplishment so far?
I think my Grammy nomination.
Oh yeah, let's give an applause for that one. Woo! Love it. Okay, yeah, definitely. I think mm-hmm. that's it. And I really pray you win it though, because that
Amen.
Would be big.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
And what about your highs and your lows? Because as much as obviously you have done so well, I'm sure you had like low moments. Mm-hmm. We've seen the really high moments. Talk about mm-hmm. it. How have you dealt with that? The high times and the low times?
Yeah, like there's sometimes like I remember when like Rush first came out and the time Rush blew up,
yeah.
I was dealing with like imposter syndrome. I was having like just wanting to be on my own, you know, like I was just in my head a lot. So that was like, you know, a very like low moment, but like I said, I'm not afraid to be seen trying, so I just keep getting better, I keep bettering myself, and that's why I'm here today. So the lows make me stronger, definitely.
Let's just touch a little bit on the imposter syndrome. Was it the 10th thing? What was it?
Eh? No.
explain further the imposter syndrome.
The imposter syndrome was more like, you know, when like you feel like you don't, because everything happened so fast. So I was just like, do I really deserve this? You know, you're just in your head a lot. No matter how, like, because I was working so hard. But at the same time, like, the devil will try to get in your head and make you feel like, oh, you're not doing enough or and all of that. But like I said, it was just in my head. And I'm so glad, like, I had people around me that could make me see that. So, yeah.
Okay, so before I move on, the stuff with Sunny Ade, right? Was it that you didn't know who he was? Explain that situation. Because I saw on social media, it was dragged a lot on.
Yeah, you know, an hour after I saw that, like, when the video was posted, just immediately the video was posted, I just had to, like, and it wasn't even up to an hour, I just put up my apology. Because, like, it was an honest mistake. Literally, the lights, it was dark.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I went back to greet everybody. You know, and the video started from after I had greeted. But it was just, it felt so like, that short clip was not what it was at all.
So tell us what it was.
Yeah, like I said, you know, the lights was dark. I couldn't see. So I was just like, I was so nervous. You could see me. I was like, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir. So in my mind, I was like, I was being very respectful. I was like, good afternoon, sir. Then when they told me it was King Sonia, I said, hey. I went back.
Okay, so that was the part of the camera you did not capture.
Yeah. But it was, yeah.
Okay, but I mean, you're someone who, I feel a few times, you know, you've had to like say your mind or just attack a troll or something, just one out of the blue. What's the greatest misconception about you?
To be honest, I don't know. What is the greatest misconception about me?
You cannot ask another person that question.
Because I don't really care about misconceptions. I can't lie.
I think I've heard you say that. But then what have you seen people say about you? That's, I mean, I know some people were saying you were rude just off this one situation. But away from that, what is it that you've seen online? I just like, really?
I feel like I don't keep all those things in my head like that. So when people do like say things about me, it's not something like I, you know, keep and I remember, like, you know, I'm very true to myself and I'm very like original, everybody.
Okay.
I just had to do that, but I'm very original and like I know who I am. So any misconceptions I don't care about all of that.
But you've seen a number of trolls online.
I mean, they're trolls all the time.
How do you handle that?
It just depends on what the vibes are saying. To be honest, now I know like my attention gives things value, so I don't give things attention anymore. Z, when it comes to attention, Z, nothing is there. But at the same time, like I think before, I used to like, you know, want to, you know, but now I don't really care too much again.
So now you're feeling like a Rihanna. You don't need to.
We all need to feel like a Rihanna, don't we? We all need to.
We're going to get to that point because I remember David Guetta saying something about that. But let's talk about your single about to drop pretty soon. I saw the video. I'm like, no. Oh. Let's talk about the song title, which is a punctuation. Commas.
Yeah.
Tell me about that song.
So, commas, like, you know, it's like 000, steady increasing the commas. It's just me saying I'm making more money, I'm doing more things for myself. And yeah, the song is just, you know, me coming back and being like, yeah, I'm that girl. You know, I made this song especially for people to just feel good and motivate everybody throughout the year. And I'm glad, like, the reception has been so beautiful and amazing. I'm really happy.
When is this going to be out?
Friday.
Just this Friday?
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to just be the video straight up out.
That's not the music video, though. That's just like...
Oh, what you dropped was just a teaser.
It's just a teaser. That was just like a teaser. You know, I always do that before a song drops. I always do like teaser content. That's like part of like my thing. So that's just like a, you know?
But have you shot the video or are you going to shoot the video?
We'll see.
I do see your sound has evolved a lot from away, right? And I think that's what happens with a lot of artists, right? And there's also what the audience wants. Because I came across an interview of yours where you said you gave quite a number of people, but it felt like they didn't really feel the song, but you like it anyway, so you're going to drop it without, you know, no feature. So how are you able to kind of like balance staying to, you know, the core of yourself and still, you know, giving people what they want?
To be honest,
yeah,
most of the things that I do, like when I release music, is because I love that song. It's because I love it. It's not because, okay, yes, 50% people are going to like the song. People are going to love the song. And my team thinks it's a great song to put out.
Yeah.
But the remaining 50 is because I'm obsessed with that song. And I've done all the TikToks to it already in my room. Mm-hmm. And I've seen that, this is my song. So it's like 50-50. I'll continue to be true to myself no matter what. And at the same time, I have to feed my fans. And I know my fans would take anything I give them as long as it's good and it's my experience.
So would you have a say in what drops at the end of the day?
Yes, definitely.
Okay. All right. So when you mentioned, was it me or you, when we talked about Rihanna?
Mm-hmm.
So David Guetta had said that, you know, he wanted you on the song. And he kind of like, you know, said he kind of saw you as the new Rihanna, you know. And I mean, I get it. Let's take away the iconic side, right? Mm-hmm. She's very edgy. She's fashionable. She's confident.
Yeah.
She's empowering. Do you see it? Do you see the Rihanna in you?
Like I said, everybody needs Rihanna in them. We need it, even though it's 2%. We need 2% of that Rihanna confidence. But like Rihanna, I grew up listening to Rihanna. Rihanna is like my number one, like, yeah, role model in everything from fashion to music to just being an iconic person. So yes, definitely. I do see it.
I saw a video. I think it was probably you singing your verse, and he was so excited, and he came to hug you.
He is the best.
Talk
he
about the experience. The best. Yeah.
No, I was. I just left my own session.
Yeah.
And my A&R called me. Was like, oh, David Guetta is having a session, and he wants you to come. I'm like, okay, I'm 5 minutes away. We drove down. We went, and he was like, he was so excited to meet me. I was like, you are the icon. What do you mean? What do you mean, sir? Yeah. I was like, hey. I was like, yes, sir. Okay, sir. But it was the best time ever. It was so good. He's a very talented man. He knows what exactly he wants. And he made me feel very comfortable in that session. I would always appreciate that forever.
Okay. I mean, it was definitely a good song.
Mm-hmm.
But still talking about attitudes and everything. What, like, because a lot of people are talking about miniskirts.
I'm wearing one today.
Yeah, I think you make it look so good. And you should really capitalize on that. Like, make some smush money.
Yes.
Right. But what's your favorite stage look? Let me ask that question.
My favorite stage look I've worn so far? Or what do I like wearing on stage?
Yeah, the most.
Mini skirts, of course.
Okay.
I like, so because I'm on stage, I like looking good. When I look good, mm-hmm, I feel good. And that's like my motto. My stylists know this. I do my makeup myself. I do my hair sometimes myself. So I just have to look good. So when I'm on stage, I like anything nice, like, you know, either like shiny, just so anything that will make me look good from any angle. So yeah.
And you like the sparkle.
I like to sparkle sometimes. Most of the time, let me know.
I mean, that's why.
Let me know. Be humble about it.
That's why you're Irish.
I like to shine.
You were on tour for most of last year. I mean, I remember, you know, your manager talking about it. I don't think you barely had any Nigerian interview last year. So do you have like tour essentials or requirements, like a room full of kittens, scented candles backstage, particular brand of bottled water?
To be honest, it's jollof rice. Everybody knows there's jollof rice on my rider. Every single place I enter, sometimes it's not good though. I just want to see it because it just reminds me of home.
Really?
And after every performance, we're just eating like rice in the room,
the
back
room.
Jollof rice. I'm not really alcohol girl like that. So it's usually jollof rice and gummy bears. But I have my own candle I take everywhere with me.
So I'm right about the scented candles.
Yes, you're right. you're very right.
What does that do to you, though?
Let me just say, like I said, we're growing every day. So sometimes, the hotels are not that great. You know? We're growing every day. We'll get to the point where, you know, yeah. But sometimes, like, some places I go to, you know, like, so I have to make it feel as good as possible. So I on my candle, you know, my bed, da-da-da-da, everywhere smelling good, my robe. I have this comfortable robe.
Mm.
Once I wear it, it's like,
Self-care.
Self-care. Self-care, yes.
Okay, so before we move to Saucy Revelations, mm-hmm, of course, Comma is going to come out on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
So what more projects are in the works for this year?
An album, definitely.
Wait, so you gave us, the last one was 19 and Dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
So is this like, how old are you now?
I'm 21.
This is like 21 and catastrophic.
We'll see you. But 21 and something. I really can't. Should I steal that? That's giving me ideas. You're giving me ideas. But so, yeah, 21 and something.
So it's going to be 21 and something more than dangerous.
Definitely problem, more than dangerous.
Problem. Okay, but then there's an album.
Yeah, there's definitely an album. I'm excited. I feel like my sound has evolved so much. Like, sonically, I don't recognize myself. Like, it's just, you know, when I listen to my music, I'm in a whole different, yeah. Like, I didn't like listening to myself, but now I like to listen to myself because it's like I'm making music that is so beautiful and I can't wait to share it with the world.
Okay, we're looking forward to that, definitely. So we're going to go to Saucy Revelations. Something I have noticed, I hope it's different with you. Maybe artists are always very careful when they come for interviews. And I really, let me look at Sean's face right now. I mean,
so, she's just like,
Okay, so I'm not going to put you in trouble.
Okay,
be sure I'm
please.
Not going to put you in trouble.
Please.
So,
this is your laugh. This is your laugh. I know what it means. I know what's coming. Hit me.
Someone you granted a feature and you wish you didn't.
Hey, to be honest, I feel like every time I get on a feature with somebody is because I love the music. Every time.
Yeah, but something can happen after. You're like, ungrateful.
Everybody is so sweet. Everybody I've worked with have been so sweet. I've been so good. No, I don't regret any single feature I've done.
Is there a feature you've done and you said, don't put this out?
Yeah, I have some that I'm like, oh, I'm not ready to put this out yet.
Yet.
Yeah, because,
you
know.
Not like ever.
No, not ever. Just, oh, there are some I've done that I'm like, I'm in a different headspace now. Let me give you another verse. Okay. Understand? Like, there's some features, like some verses I recorded, like, 2022. I know they want to release it now. And it's like, oh, let me give you another verse. I'm in a different, I know I can do something way harder than this. So, yeah.
So, not a total tell-off.
What?
Not a total tell-off.
No.
Someone that you like to collaborate with because you sort of resonate with your vibes. Obviously, you haven't done it yet.
Mm-hmm.
So, who's that person?
Rihanna.
I saw the answer coming.
Rihanna.
Well, here's the thing. She's not even dropping music.
You don't know. I've heard some things. You don't know. Maybe. I'm praying. I'm actually fasting. I'm praying. I can't lie. I'm praying.
At this point, we're not even sure.
Yeah, but Rihanna, SZA.
Oh, that's a good one.
I love SZA. Thames, obviously, that's my girl for life. Burner Boy. Rema.
I'm not sure you don't have a song with Burner.
Not yet.
Why don't you have a song with
it's
Rema?
Coming soon.
3 years.
Coming soon. We have music. We're looking for the right one.
Do you see yourself with any Jamaican artists?
Definitely. Popcan.
Mm-hmm.
Popcan, definitely. Motima. I like Motima. Yeah, I think those are my top, like, Jamaican artists I want to work with.
Any female?
Yes.
Who?
Spice.
Okay.
I like Spice.
I thought you were going to say Jada Kingdom. Or
yeah, Jada too. Of course. Jada, everybody. Okay.
Fair enough. If you were asked to snitch on an industry colleague for $1 billion, not dollars, naira, would you do that? Don't even lie.
If I was asked to snitch on what?
An industry colleague. For $1 billion.
A billion what?
Naira.
I'll snitch you. I will snitch with all my chest and all my heart. I'm like, auntie, I.
So, my next question. Aside, you can pick your song. What's your favorite song from last year?
Favorite songs from last year. Everything on SZA's album. First, Tyler Water. Second, third, Victoria Monet, All Right.
Interesting. Yeah. So all females, girl power.
Yes.
Speaking of Tyler, though, there was this song that you guys did together, Girl Next Door.
Girl Next Door.
I really like that song. It's so sweet.
Thank you so much.
I love it.
Yes.
But this is you're telling me this is your favorite song from last year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I can't play the song, but it's called What's Up. Why? Yeah. Why are you obsessed with it?
Because it's such a good song. It's so beautifully crafted. Her voice is beautiful. And it makes me feel good. And I like to, you know.
concert where you guys sang Girl Next Door. Mm-hmm. So that was the first time I honestly knew who she was. And eventually she dropped What. I'm like, oh, okay. But let's move away from Tyler there. Who has thrown the littest party that you have been to?
The littest party that I have been to. What's the littest party I've been to?
You've gone to so many lit parties that you...
Yeah, but to be honest, it has to be my party. I feel like every party that every after party, anything that is, I'm there, I'm the life of parties. Everybody's going to have fun. Everybody knows this. Everybody knows this. My party is always the best.
So what goes down in your party?
It's just like, I feel like everybody is so much more free because I'm free. I'm not standing there and like, you know, forming. I'm having the time of my life. Let's go, like, everybody have a good time. Shots. Everybody, like, you know, yeah.
Just look at Ira. Our party is the latest party ever.
Yes.
Okay, I'll take that. Hopefully I send one soon. So I'll see how lit it is.
Let's see.
Okay, so a man is sexiest when he's wearing what?
When he's wearing... I don't even know.
What do you mean, don't know?
I can't think of it. I can't...
So you ever seen a man and be like, oh, he looks really sexy?
Yeah, but like, I don't know. Is it the... When he looks good. A man is sexy when he looks good. When,
like,
he's wearing...
Like when he's wearing a tuxedo?
No, maybe just when he looks good. When he's confident. A man is sexy when he wears his confidence.
Okay,
yes.
That kind of works. So yes. Regardless of what he's putting on.
Yeah, it's just the confidence. And no skinny jeans, but yeah, confidence.
Would you forgive a cheating partner?
I mean, what? No. No.
Have you ever cheated?
No.
You've never cheated?
How are you looking shocked? Have you ever cheated?
No.
Girl, say the truth.
No, this is a safe space. No.
Let me know. Teach me.
Friends of benefit is different from being in the relationship. But in the relationship, I've never cheated. So that's your answer.
I like this. I like what I'm hearing.
What's a song that must make it to your wedding playlist?
Justin Timberlake, Mirrors. You are the love of my life. That has to be played. I don't care. See, that 8 minutes while on the dance floor.
Good choice, yeah. Definitely. Do you have any tattoos? I don't see any.
I have two tattoos.
Where?
I have one on my back and I have one on my side.
What does it mean?
It's supposed to be a cross. But it wasn't, tattoo artist wasn't that great. So it looks like an addition sign. Okay. It's like a plus. Then I have like wings at my back because like celestial being. I'm a celestial being, you know.
That's definitely understandable. Obviously you're a sensational, the guys love you. What's the craziest DM you have? You've got so many crazy DMs. Not asking, I'm guessing. I know.
You're having such a great time. I can just see your eyes. Your eyes are so happy.
So what's the craziest DM you have gotten from a male fan?
I've gotten a bunch of crazy DMs, I can't lie. I don't know about craziest. I feel like there's nothing my eyes has not seen at this point. So there's nothing too crazy.
Have you seen like a guy's penis just like that?
Hey.
I'm just asking. That everything has happened.
Everything has happened.
But how do you handle this though? You're used to it at this point.
Blocked. Blocked.
I understand. But what's a skill or hobby that you wish you had more time to pursue outside of your career, which is music and singing? Mm-hmm.
I wish I had more time to learn about horse riding. I feel like I find horse riding very calming and it's something I'm starting to like. And yeah, I wish I had more time to do that.
Nice. I didn't see that coming, definitely. What's the one aspect of your life that fame hasn't stripped away from you?
I don't feel like fame has stripped away anything at all, to be honest. I still do everything I used to do, you know? I still go out with my friends. I still...
Do you still have
maybe
the same
sleep? Hey.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
I used to love to sleep before. I used to love to sleep very well. But now, you know, I'm working, so, like, I don't get to sleep as much.
That's understood. But every other thing on check.
Yeah, everything is good.
So you're not one of those people who got famous and, you know, you don't have enough time for your friends and you start to lose some friends?
Not really. I saw my best friends that I've not seen like a whole year. I saw them December last year in Cotonou. So that was good. We have a group chat. We still talk, you know. So everybody understands. Everybody's doing their thing. So
I think that's good, because most people get famous and it's like, you know, life has changed.
So. No, not really.
Okay, so we're going to get to the rapid fire roundup. So
it's all
like
right.
It's like a this or that.
Just okay.
Pick quick.
Let's go.
Studio recording or live performances?
Live performances.
Live performances. Speaking of recording, do you like recording at night or during the day?
I like recording at night.
Why?
Because I'm just used to that. My first time in the studio was in Maven Studio, and I used to record all night.
Oh, okay.
So I think I'm just programmed like that now.
What do you see yourself as? A baddie, a diva, or another option?
I see myself as a star.
Yeah, just aside of being a star.
Yeah, I just see myself as a star, you know, a cutie, a nice girl.
So we'll take cutie.
A beautiful girl. So yeah.
Okay. Candlelit dinner or a spontaneous rooftop picnic?
Candlelit dinner.
Candlelit dinner.
Yeah. Because that spontaneous rooftop picnic doesn't sound fun. Like, be spontaneous and do something else, okay? That's spontaneous and take me on a helicopter ride.
Okay. All right. I think that should bring my next question. Material girl or self-sufficient queen?
Both.
That could pass. Oh. Role play or truth or dare?
Huh?
Role play or truth or dare?
What's that?
Well, I don't understand.
What's role play or truth or dare?
Role play is playing a role.
Oh.
Truth or dare is truth or dare.
Truth or dare? That's what I know.
BDE or a big spender?
What's BDE?
So I have to put up the mic to tell her what BDE is. Or a big spender?
Is it like this or that? I have to choose one.
Yeah, I have to choose one.
Both.
But if you had to pick one, which one are you picking?
I'll pick both, because I am both. So
you have it.
It's the energy. It's the energy. And I am a big spender, so it has to be reciprocated. I'll be reciprocal.
Okay.
Yeah.
Beard.
What? Yes.
Beard or clean shaven?
Clean.
Clean shaven. Are you a top or bottom girl?
Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire.
That's on my leave, by the way. Holy Ghost fire.
A Jesus girl. How about that? Yes.
Eye rolling.
I'm a Jesus girl. I'm a child of God.
Okay, transform into a different animal every time you sneeze, or speak in a different accent every time you laugh.
Speak in a different accent every time I laugh.
You don't want to transform into like a goat, lion, pigeon.
No, please.
This is also an absurd question. Feature in a song battle with aliens or a sensual duet with a ghost?
Hey, I'm gonna pick the aliens though, because this ghost, like, I'm sensual what? With ghosts?
Yes, no.
Eh? Holy Ghost fire. No. No. So, aliens. Okay, aliens. I picked that. Like, what's
Why
up, my guy?
Why are you running away from ghosts? All this confidence dies.
No. Aliens.
Nasty or classy?
Classy and nasty.
Pick one now.
Both.
One.
Both. I know how to be both. But classy, I'm a classy girl.
Bartender or stripper?
After this or that.
Yeah.
Bartender.
Okay. Okay, so I have to go because my show ends in a bit, actually, unfortunately. But for people who are listening to you, what you had to say to them?
If you're listening to me, I love you so much and I know you love me. Commas is coming out on Friday. Go stream it and enjoy yourselves. Follow me everywhere on socials, Iris Star.
Okay, that is STAR. Thank you so much. I had fun talking to you, definitely.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. I'm looking forward to all the projects that you have to drop as well. Lava Lounge with TK ends in a few minutes, so stick around. I'll be right back to wrap up the show. Again, this is dropping on Friday. It's called Komaz, and I'm playing it again right here on Hot 93.3 FM. I'll be right back to wrap up the show. And that's the interview with...
It's a vibe on Lava Lounge. 93.3.